Hello, fabulous Taurus. Welcome to your horoscope for the year of 2016, looking at life and love. I am your astrologer, Nadia Shaw. Thank you for being here, and a very big happy new year to everyone out there. This year, right out of the gate, we are starting with a Mercury retrograde. And the Mercury retrogrades to take place this year, okay, so usually there's three every year. This year is no exception to that rule. So we've got three Mercury retrogrades taking place that will characterize much of this year, and they are all happening in Earth signs, fellow Earth signs, which means that in many ways you are going to be considering matters of fulfillment, matters of happiness, matters of an understanding of where you're going and what really matters, and matters of what really resonates with all Earth signs out there, manifestation. A part of you is going to start to get clear on who you are. And it isn't just about knowing who you are. It isn't just about this concept, but about actually living it. And where it is that maybe you felt like you've been making a little bit too many compromises, this is going to be a time when you get clear about your direction. And for some of you out there, you might even start to go in bold new directions. For others of you out there, if you know that you are on the right path in life, in love, in what it is that you are doing, moving towards and experiencing more and more of what matters to you most, then those gains will be solidified, further solidified, to ensure that you continue to make gains for many years to come. We have solid progress being made. The key time for you really is going to be in the spring, of course, when the Mercury retrograde in your sign takes place. But really, there are so many moments this year that are so key and that are going to speak to the heart of you. So we have this Earth Mercury retrograde energy taking place, and then you add to that the continuation of a supremely harmonious conversation also taking place in Earth signs and fellow Earth signs with Jupiter in Virgo and Pluto in Capricorn. So this again is speaking to matters of fulfillment, especially where it comes to your creativity. Are you living with enough passion? A lot of times Taurians can be very diligent, very on the path, and that's part of the beauty, right? You can see things that are present. You can see the details. You can see what's happening right now in a way that other signs that might be more caught up in the vision in the future might not necessarily always get. You can see what it is and the quality of what it is that you're producing, the satisfaction that it's producing. And with that clear vision, that allows you to manifest even more and more beautiful things in love, in life, and in your successes. So we have the continuation of this conversation. This to me says that if you want to have children, you've got lots of cosmic support to make that happen. If you want to get started on that big creative project or dedicate yourself to something that truly matters to you, set yourself on a path of self-actualization or commit yourself to your art, commit yourself to what it is that you are genuinely passionate about and what you believe ultimately will allow you to realize a bigger vision, a larger vision, a vision that you can really get excited about, that will become that much more clear. So there are solid gains that are going to be made now, and they will not just be superficial. There is manifestation. There is career success happening here. There is a material element to this as well, a financial element to this as well. But what it does come down to, what it really comes down to, is that you start entering a different energy. You start accessing an energy of happiness, of abundance, of prosperity, and your life starts to reflect that. By the time we get to the later part of the year, Jupiter will move into a sign that is very, very fortunate in terms of work. There'll be more than enough work, more than enough clients, and lots to keep you busy also, and lots of satisfaction and support to be had in those environments. Also, as we get you to the later part of the year, more and more you're going to be moving towards a sense of breakthroughs. Now, some of these breakthroughs are going to be largely personal, largely energetic, but they will have a sweeping effect on your life and will continue into 2017. In matters of love, what we have this year is Mars retrograde season. So last year, Venus retrograde season, incredibly important to you because your ruling planet is Venus. This year, it's Mars retrograde, and Mars is actually going to be retrograding in and out of your opposite sign. This suggests that you are working on a relationship, working to understand love, where you are in love and why, and working to make meaningful changes take place. So if you are in an established bond, this could be a time where you are asked to give more of your energy to that bond, to express your commitment, or just to be present for your significant other. If you are open to experiencing new love, to greater love, this is going to be a time when that desire will be especially heightened, which means that you are likely to take more chances, put yourself out there more, and doing that alone will ensure that you'll be attracting all kinds of interesting, at the very least, interesting experiences that you're likely going to be talking about to your friends for a very, very long time to come. But either way, you're learning about love, you're opening your heart, you're understanding where love is meant to be easy. There is a work that always happens in the context of relationships, always. And it is the work of ultimately seeing who you are as reflected in the eyes of another. And where it is that you don't like what you see, that is your work to do. But there are some relationships that bring up this work in ways that are easy, harmonious, and others that do it in ways that are a little bit more abrupt, right? A little bit more jarring. So you're gonna have to decide where you are within that, you know, frame of reference, within that spectrum, and are you okay with it? What is it that fundamentally needs to change within you, with the person that you're with, the dynamic, or with the type of people that you are attracting? You will at the very least get some powerful insights into why you want what you want, why you've been sort of driven to. You know how sometimes you meet people and you have this like kind of energetic reaction to them? Well, this is going to be an awareness of why you're having that. Where does that come from? Having that sense of appreciation, of knowing that it isn't about being on automatic, and you don't have to be on automatic, and you can decide what it is that draws you to a person. You can decide what it is that turns, really, if I may say, that lights you up, right? That fires you up when it comes to meeting someone new. And as you make that decision, you are going to find yourself moving towards a love of greater maturity and moving towards a love that ultimately will give you more of what you know you deserve. Someone who's able to match your level of consistency and commitment. Someone who's able to match your level of willingness to work, but also willingness to experience a sense of peace and a sense of unity. With this state of spirit and with this genuine desire and a genuine understanding of what your work is and where it isn't, you can't help but experience love that becomes more and more healthy and more strong. What I love about this year for you is that there's this great balance happening. You're achieving great things. You are more and more proud of yourself as we move further and further into the year. And these achievements come from a true sense of self-knowledge. From there, love becomes more possible to you as well. Meaningful changes become possible to you as well. And from there, a more essential self comes forward. A more essential self that knows what really matters, that knows what you're really going for, and what love truly requires, and what love doesn't require. With all that clarity, you can't help but find yourself moving in a direction of greater success, greater financial progress, and of course, greater heartfelt connections to other people.